Hello students, this is Monica, PGD in Computer Science from Sri GK Jain High Secondary School. Today I'm going to teach for 11th Standard Computer Science Chapter 10 Flow of Control. And this is the continuation of my Part 1 video. In my Part 1 video, I told you about the sequence statements and selection statements. I'm continuing in that. Selection statements, the next one is your if-else-if ladder. It is nothing but it is a multi-path decision making statement. In this statement, one if condition is followed by one or more else if conditions, and finally will be concluded with the else statement. And here is an example. Inside your main function, the if condition is m indicates the marks. If it is greater than or equal to 16, then your output will be first class. If it is false, then your control will jump to your else if statement. In else if statement, it checks the condition. If mark is greater than or equal to 50, less than 60. So your mark will be 50 to 59. If your mark, whatever the user enters the mark, if it lies between this range, then the output will be second class. If it is false, then the condition again jumps to the else if. In the else if statement, it again checks with the condition. Mark is greater than or equal to 40. So from 40 to 49. If your mark lies between in that range, then your output will be third class. If your mark is not in these ranges, automatically the control will jump to the else statement and that returns your output as failed. So this is your if-else-if ladder. And the next is your conditional statement. And this conditional statement is a ternary operator. Ternary operator in the sense you can use three operands. It is an alternative to your if-else statement. The expression with the condition, it will check in this place. If that condition is tends to be true, then it executes the expression true. If it is false, then the control jumps to the expression 3. So it is an alternative for your if condition with the else statement. And here is an example for your conditional statement. Inside your main function, I am declaring the variables A, B and marks. Marks indicates the maximum number. Here we are trying to find out the maximum numbers of two numbers, A and B. Output C out will be your statement like enter two numbers. So whatever numbers is being entered by the user will be assigned by a CN statement to the variable A and B. So if suppose the user enters 10 and 20, so A will have the 10 value and B declared with the 20 value. And the condition is that max is equal to, if A is greater than B, then your output will be A. If it is false, then your output will be B. This is a condition. And whatever the user giving is the A and B value. I told you 10 and 20. So it checks with the value 10 and 20. If 10 is greater than 20, no, it is false. So your output will be B. So the output statement, largest number with the colon, the output will be 20. The maximum number, whatever you are giving, that number will be printed in your output console. So this is your conditional statement. The next type of statement is your if statement. If statement, you can call it as, it's a multi-way branching statement. That is, the execution part can be jumped from one part of your program to the another. It can move independently based on the values of the execution, that is in your switch. Here is an example for switch. Before going to the example, we have certain rules for declaring a switch. Whatever expressions you are giving in the switch statement, that should result in a constant value. Otherwise, the switch statement would not be valid. And you can use the nesting options in the switch also. And the default case will be an optional statement. Whether you can use it a default case or you cannot use it also. And the next one, will be your example for the switch statement. Inside my main function, I am declaring here a variable num. In the cout statement, I am giving the output statement as enter weekday number. So whatever number is entering by the user will be assigned to the variable num, and that value will be given to the switch statement for the condition checking. If suppose the user gave number as 2, case 1 will not executed, it will move to the case 2 because the number is 2. The output will be Monday. If suppose the number whatever given by the user is 7, so based on the number the output will be varied. The default case, if the user gives more than 7, so the output will be your wrong input. So this is an example for your switch statement. And next is your nested switch. Nested switch in the sense you can use a switch statement in the sequential statement of your another switch statement, and the constant value of your inner switch and outer switch may be or may not be same. You can give the different values for the constants also. And here is an example. Inside my main function, I am initializing and declaring a variable. I am initializing the value with 8 to the variable a, and the output given here, the number is whatever a is 8. Switch off a is nothing but the value will be given here to the switch statement, and based on the values, if the number is 0, you will get this. If the number is non-zero, you will get the default statement, and the switch will be passed over to your next inner switch also. Because the number is non-zero, so int b is equal to a modulus of 2. So whatever number you are giving here will be taken modulus by the value 2, so that output will be 0. So b takes the value 0, so you will get the output as a even number in your program. So you will get one output as non-zero and you will get one more output as even number. So the 8 is a non-zero number with a even condition. So this is an output for your nested switch. And the next topic is differentiation of your switch statement with the if-else statement. The comparison, like both the statements are selection statements, whereas in your if-else statement, you can use multiple choices for multiple statements. But whereas in your switch statement, you have to use a single statement for the multiple choice by giving the case values from 1 to infinite. In your if-else statement, if your condition tends to be false, then your else statement will be executed. Whereas in your switch statement, if your condition whatever you are giving is false, then your default statement will be executed. And if you are in your if-else statement, it can valid for all the data types starting from integer, boolean, character, string, float, double. Whereas in your if statement, you can only carry with a integer or with the character data types. So basically the if statement is more flexible than your switch statement. And from this, your selection statements topic got over, and this video will be continuing for you, like for explanation of your iteration statements. Thank you, students.